The last couple of weeks here on the channel, we've put together a couple of pretty wacky systems. First, it was a tiny HTPC. And then last week, we built maybe the dumbest PC on YouTube. Granted, you know, we did it on purpose, but still, kind of weird. Today, we're getting back to basics. We're doing an all AMD gaming system that will serve you well for years to come. Need a Windows or Office key but don't want to pay retail? MMORC.com has all the best deals and a sweet discount for BPS Customs viewers. Just head over to the site link below and enter code BAN35 for 35% off your order total, meaning you could snag Windows 10 Home for under 10 bucks. Fill out your email and place your order and then click the extract code button at the top of the page. From there, it's as easy as heading to your Windows activation settings and inputting your shiny new key. For more information, head to MMORC.com or check out the links below. Now, when I set out to put this system together for you guys, originally the goal was going to be a $1,000-ish gaming build. However, due to current circumstances, doing that is very, very difficult. I'm not saying that it can't be done, or if we made a few changes that we couldn't achieve that goal, but the problem right now is that there are so many parts that are just out of stock, or if they're in stock, the prices are ridiculously jacked up, that it's really hard to both hit that price target and use some of the parts that I really wanted to feature in a build like this. So we're going to proceed under the assumption that under quote unquote normal circumstances, this would be about a $1,000 build. Now there are going to be a couple of optional extras that we're going to be using here, like these fans specifically, that you don't really need to include if you're trying to hit a certain price target. However, like I said, just because of the situation that we are in globally right now, it is very difficult to pinpoint exactly the prices of some of these items. Power supplies are out of stock everywhere. These B550 motherboards are impossible to find. And, you know, even graphics cards and processors are really hit or miss. So just know that if you wanted to do something like this, you might be better off waiting a few months until things kind of normalize. In the interim, we will continue to put systems together on this channel. We do it every week. So be sure to get subscribed if you don't want to miss any of that, because we try to do different price points, different performance targets, different form factors, and anything else you guys might want to see. We're going to start off, as we often do, with the processor. And this right here is AMD's Ryzen 5 3600X. I've used it many times before on the channel, and with good reason. It's an excellent choice for gaming, for low-end content creation. It's just basically their all-rounder CPU. However, for this specific build, I would recommend deleting the X and just going with the base Ryzen 5 3600. The performance between the two are going to be extremely similar. It's just a matter of a couple hundred megahertz clock speed and maybe some overclocking potential, but the way that AMD's third generation Ryzen processors perform is that it's almost better to just leave them on their own and let PBO kind of do its thing, boost up your cores as high as they'll go based on your thermal solution, and just kind of make it easy on yourself to get really, really good gaming performance. So Ryzen 5 3600 slash 3600X is what we're basing this on. To cool our processor, we're going with the Xatix Spark AIO. Now, a couple of weeks ago, we used their Spark memory in a build, and at that time, I talked to you guys about the availability of Xatix products in North America, and it is slim to none. This really doesn't exist in a North American market. Amazon, Newegg, B&H, none of them carry these products. So they sent these over to me, and I did want to check them out and use them in a build, but if you're going to be building this and you live in North America, you're gonna have to try something different and or maybe just stay with the stock AMD cooler. But this is a 240 millimeter all-in-one. It's got some RGB effects and hopefully it should be plenty to cool our Ryzen 5 chip. We are gonna be swapping out the fans on the Spark AIO for these from Deepcool. These are their brand new MF120 GT fans. They have decent airflow properties and decent static pressure. Not the best in either, but good for our use case here. And they look pretty cool as well. We're gonna put them on the radiator for the Spark and we're gonna populate our case with them. We've got 2 3-packs here and we'll check out how they perform. Now, the centerpiece of our system is gonna be this brand new motherboard from MSI. This is the MAG B550 Gaming Carbon Wi-Fi. The biggest problem that I have with these new B550 motherboards is not necessarily going to be their performance, because especially for a Ryzen 5 chip, this is gonna be awesome. However, it's just the price. In the past, the B series of boards, the B350, B450 boards, have been significantly less expensive than their X counterparts, X370, X470, now X570. However, this one is not. This one is about $220. For that price, you can get a really decent X570 board. Do you want that? That's up to you. But the B550 boards are supposed to be mostly fully featured, still PCIe 4.0, and also give you a little price advantage over the X570 counterparts. Now, granted, if you look at some of MSI's X570 boards, like the MAG Ace, like their Creation boards, those are extraordinarily expensive. This offers most of that performance, most of those features for way less money, but still, I wouldn't qualify as cheap. So that's my biggest gripe with B550 boards right now, is prices aren't really that much less than X570, but they are less. So my recommendation, if you're gonna be building this and you wanted to save some cash, would be to go B450. B450 boards still work great with the Ryzen 5 chips, and you can get them for a lot less money. Our graphics card for today's build is gonna be from Sapphire. It's gonna be the Pulse version of the 5600 XT. I tested this when it first came out. This was one of, if not the best performing 5600 XTs, especially when you take price into consideration. This is maybe one of the cheapest 5600 XTs, and it still performs like one of the best. So I really did enjoy testing this out, playing some games with it, and I think it's gonna go really well in today's build. For memory, we're going with a 2x8GB kit of Corsair's Vengeance Pro RGB memory. This is the white version, and the reason we're going with the white version is because our case happens to be white. However, you could get these in black or in white, multiple different speeds, and it's Corsair memory. It's always gonna look really good and perform really solidly with almost any setup. And then for storage, we're gonna use an Intel 660p SSD. This happens to be a 2 terabyte version. In my price list that I parted out, I put a 1 terabyte version because storage is very personal. Do what's best for you. Pick the amount of storage that you need for what you feel you're gonna be doing with your system. And finally, what are we gonna be building in? What is the TD500 mesh version from Cooler Master. They sent over the white version of this case. There is black and white. That's why we're going with the white memory. But we saw this at CES. It looked pretty cool, and it's only about $100. Full mesh front, 3 ARGB fans that we will be swapping out, but you wouldn't necessarily need to. But it's got a decent layout, a decent amount of space. For $100, I think it seems like a really good value, but we'll see when we build in it how things go. So that is our parts list today. About $1,000 PC if everything was normal. Unfortunately, that's not the case, but still, I think you can achieve similar performance to this if you made a few cuts here and there, specifically the fans, maybe the AIO, but what we're basing our performance numbers on is a Ryzen 5 3600, a B550 motherboard, and a 5600 XT. That is really the core of this build, and we'll see how those perform together right now. great way to get back to basics, back to building a quote-unquote normal gaming system, something that you guys would be happy to build at home and have on your desk. After a couple weeks of strange builds, problems with components, having to swap things out, having noise issues or performance issues, or a purposefully poorly designed and built PC, this was refreshing. It was nice to get back to building something that all came together so well. Now, you'll probably notice that I did go with a set of extensions in here. Again, that is an added extra that does bump the cost up a little bit, but I did want to feature these Silverstone black extensions. They look pretty good, and they definitely add a little bit to the interior of our case. And I did want to talk about that case. As it turns out, the TD500 Mesh is a really well thought out, well designed, and well built chassis. I was a little surprised coming in at under $100 what you get for your money. The fans that we didn't use here are all white. They were addressable RGB and they were mounted all at the front. We did swap them out for our deep cools, but you get three fans with this system. Also, you have captive thumb screws on the side panel glass, which I don't think I've ever seen before, and it was a really cool feature. That side glass does have this cool little etching design. Not a game changer, but it's just interesting. It's something a little bit different. I like that Cooler Master did that. Kind of carries the pattern from the front mesh across the side. Now, whether you think that front mesh is kind of a ripoff of Fractal's Meshify, well, that's up to you. The fact remains that it performs really well. Thermally and acoustically, this case seems really well done. And that's kind of evidenced by the temperatures that we were getting while we were gaming. The GPU was staying in the 50s, the CPU mostly in the 40s. Those temperatures did vary with certain loads, but for the most part, they were well under any kind of thermal threshold, allowing both of them to boost up appropriately. So we had great thermals across the board, and that's definitely due to the amount of airflow coming through this chassis, directed from the front and then out the back and out the top. Enabling that really good airflow in our system were the MF120 GT fans from Deepcool. And I am really glad that I got a chance to use these because they definitely impressed me. While we said in the beginning they don't have the best static pressure, it was good enough to push air through a radiator, especially on a mid-range processor. But what really is the feature of them is how they look. They're built kind of in reverse. So you have your standard fan hub at the back of the frame. So looking at these fans from the back, they look really good. They look like any other normal RGB fan would. And then when you flip them around and you see that X, which is, I guess, their feature, that even looks better. So these look good from either side, which is something that not a lot of fans can actually say. And they're not all that expensive. It's $60 for three of them with a controller. So it's still $20 per fan, but you do get that controller. And compared to something like Corsair fans, which could be $120 for a three pack, that seems kind of like a bargain. And I guess we do have to wrap up by talking about our gaming performance. Now, we used the 5600 XT, and as we tested when these cards first came out, the 5600 XTs across the board are just absolutely dominating 1080p gaming right now. There are a couple offerings from NVIDIA that can give it a run for its money, but just looking at pure 1080p performance, it's hard to beat the Sapphire Pulse version of the 5600 XT. DX11, DX12, Vulcan, all really great performance. Generally, we're sitting maybe an average in the 80s as far as frame rate goes. If you don't talk about Doom Eternal, between 160 and 180 frames per second. And these are all 1080p Ultra. So if 1080p is your target, just like we talked about in our initial review, the 5600 XT is maybe the go-to card right now. And when you pair it with something like a 3600, or I guess in our case, a 3600X, you're just gonna get absolutely fabulous results and gameplay that it just blows away so many other of the lower end options when it comes to GPUs. So that is a wrap for this week's build. Make sure to get subscribed if you like this kind of content. You wanna see more PC builds because we do them here every week. So thank you so much for watching, guys. As always, I hope you enjoyed this video. Links to everything is down below in the video description, and I will see you next time.